Hi guys, it's Ramon. I've talked to you guys in a long time. I've been kind of busy with my campaign, upgraded, and other things. I'm probably not an ally, but no more MS Hobart. Please check it out. Anyway, I want to talk to you guys about a few things. Laron, you're doing a great job, man. Awesome. I haven't talked to you guys in a while, but I wanted to touch base and tell you guys, look, I know MS is a horrible, slur, just piece of crap thing to be messing with, but we can't just give up. We can't just stop. I mean, 9 years ago, and most of you know, I was in the hospice. A few years after that, I wrote a book, and then I wrote another book, and now I'm running around Congress. And I was a quadriplegic. I think I turned that around. That's, you know, if you think about it, I kind of turned that around. Also, I just got the spot back for my commercial. It looks great. So that'll be up soon when I get the okay. But I want to let you guys know that don't just give up. Always dream. Always. I mean, no matter what, you can do it. I mean, I know it's hard. I know with some people it's difficult. I know some people get this and they go, wow, what a tunnel I'm in. But that's it. Remember, darkness in your life. All darkness is absence of light. That means something is blocking your light. So maybe you should look up and see, what is it that's blocking my light? What is blocking my hope? What is? That's all you have to ask yourself. What is? Because when you don't ask yourself those questions and that question, and you don't put it in your own head, no more MS prison sucking your own mind, you give up hope. And that's what we're trying with Laron, that's with Natalie, that's what I'm trying to do, is make sure that you guys keep hope going. Because you always can get to the next stage. Always. And even when you don't expect it, I know what you believe in. I mean, if you believe in whatever, I don't care. But there's always, always something. And hopefully you have a great mental attitude. And that's the thing. Keep a PMA. Positive mental attitude. Keep that going. Don't let the naysayers and the negativity and the people out there get you. Because I've had plenty of stuff come up with the campaign that I was just like, I don't know why I'm doing this. It's not worth it. But I'm going to keep going now. I didn't make the ballot. What I mean by ballot is, in campaign speak, you have to get a certain amount of signatures to go to the ballot. I was a couple hundred short. That's all right. But I want to say I was only 3 people working on the campaign. That's pretty impressive for the fact that some people have hundreds of people working on the campaign. Tens, hundreds, tens, 20s, 30s. If I would have had 2 or 3 more people out there helping me with the campaign, I might have got this interest. I still am on the ballot as a writing candidate. I'm not going to give up. This is not the end for me. I'm still taking our message and MS and all that to our government some sort of way. I'm doing it. I'm going to make sure that we're heard. Because, see, they always talk about the not heard people, the people that are not represented. Really? You know, what demographic is less represented than disabled African Americans? But hey, they have a great movement with Black Lives Matter. And I'm all for it. That's what my whole campaign's about, is move forward united. We need to, because if we don't bring disabled folks on to the table, then there's no point. Because you can say, hey, let's get America going, a small business and all that stuff like that. But guess what? If you're shooting blacks and shooting Hispanics left and right and not letting them go to the border and separating their kids from their parents, you're doing some barbaric stuff. Nothing is going to change. Nothing's going to be right. Nothing in this world. And this is America. America. So we got to really step up to what we are. And we need to stop talking at each other and talk to each other. Because this press this, you're never going to bring the other side of people who disagree with you to be a part of this. If you don't talk with them and understand that their point of view is valid, you might not agree. You might not agree with anything I'm saying, but guess what? At least take the time to listen and try to step out your own. So stop being a me society. Stop being a me. It's pretty much like a Donald Trump. And I'm sorry. I will say it. I don't agree with that man, but I do respect the presidency. I do respect him to have his opinion. But his job, he turns into the optics of his job, is to help us Americans. But if you're fighting for other countries, come on. Anyway, I don't want to get into that because that's a just divisive thing. But really, he's the rooster guy. He's a rooster. Anyway, so just really don't give up hope. I haven't. I'm going to take this campaign to the very end. And actually, it's not going to end because I'm going to keep going. But anyway, I want to touch base with my group and my guys, and thank you guys for hanging in there and being a part of this. I'm back. I'm with you guys. I'm going to try to do this more often. You know that. And Natalie's been really on me about doing this, so I'm here for you guys. Take it easy. Remember that you cannot, should not be a part of your